The Power of Exclusiveness in Differentiation. Hi, I am Dr. Vasant Khisty. I am based out of India and I have done my PhD in Global Competitiveness of Auto Industry. I am here to present an exclusive program on the power of exclusivity and differentiation. The theme of this program is basically to understand how to increase your effort to return ratio by being different. The takeaway after this training would be how to position yourself to get a premium for yourself or the products that you manufacture. I am here because I wish to be exclusive, different, and I don't want to be a carbon copy. I have failed and succeeded in several jobs, failed in several businesses and lost all my wealth 3 times, but I choose to stand up and give one more try in life. I have this idea and I am passionate about the same. I have tried this on myself and many other people and companies, and we have reaped great benefits out of being exclusive and different. I have a mascot for this program and his name is Aladdin. He is a young man who lost his hand in a truck accident. He had 2 choices. One was to self-pity and become a beggar, and the other was to use one hand to do his work. He can open up a tire, remove the puncture and fit it back on the truck. He substitutes his lost hand with his knees, elbow, head, shoulder, and he has found his way to work around his limitation. And there is no limitation if you don't have any limitation in your mind. Some people just never give up their journey towards their goals. I have loaded this PowerPoint presentation on AuthorStream and I got a notification that 15,000 people have seen the same. For me, it is just an idea I am passionate about. And I have testimonies of people and organizations who claim they have achieved success implementing this idea. I have shared this in many schools and colleges, organizations, and I am sure people are benefiting. It is applicable for human beings and organizations providing products and various services. I like this quote. 2 roads diverged in the woods and I took the road less traveled, and that has made all the difference. In life we always have 2 options, one difficult, the other easy. The road which has a crowd is an easy option and the road which is lonely is a difficult option. Climbing Mount Everest was a difficult option which many people tried and failed until Sir Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay climbed it, and Edmund Hillary got the title of Sir. Try not to become a man of success but rather become a man of value. There is a difference between value and the cost. The cost of a nail is just a rupee or a cent, but the value of that nail in a chariot is immense, as a war was lost for a broken nail. So the focus should be about adding value rather than focus on success, as value is the result of series of success and failures, and even when we fall down, we can pick up something. We have seen the evolution of mobile cell phone from a cordless phone to an advanced cell phone in less than 20 years. The first mobile cell phone with an antenna has a zero value, and an Apple iPhone costs $1,000. But then there will be a time 100 years from now, the value of the first cell phone will fetch more than $100,000, as it will have an antique value. Hence, value is perspective changing with the time. And what is the value of Nokia now? Life always can be divided into 2 halves, the first half and the second half. What you do in the first half defines the second half. If you work hard in the first half, which is up to say 20 years, you can have a better second half. And if you enjoy the first half without adding value, there is a probability that you will struggle for the rest of your life. A person who spends exercising in the first half will have stronger bones in the second half, and life will be relatively easier than someone who has not done any kind of exercise. There are 2 situations in life. Either you are standing in a queue or the queue stands behind you. This decides the value or the price you get for your product or for services. There was a time when there would be a waiting period of 8 years to get a Bajaj scooter. Times have changed and there is no queue left, as people have options. Now there is a waiting period for other products which have evolved and give better value for money. Similarly, people stand in queue to watch a movie or to get a job. Destiny versus free will has always been a point of debate. For a successful person, he feels he is self-made and he did all the hard work. For a failure, he puts blame on destiny. Destiny is like a ghost, which can't be proven. A Sufi saint put it in simple words. Where you peg the cow with a rope is its destiny, and the free will is the length of the rope which allows it to do anything within the circumference. There are several quotes on fate and destiny. Some of them I like are, fate is what you are given, destiny is what you make out of it. Destiny is not a matter of chance, it is a matter of choice. Some things are destined to be, it needs a couple of tries to be there. Does the walker choose the path or the path chooses the walker? Everyone has his perspective and experience of his life and destiny, and fate cannot be proved. Can we change the past? We cannot change the past. Every one of us is at a certain point in life and we can't go back and correct it. What we can do is decide that here on I will take charge of my life. I shall study hard, work hard, read, write, exercise, and at least try to do something to change our situation. Can destiny stop you from exercising? If dumbbell falls on your feet, you do push-up with your hand. We can always find something to do around our limitations. There are dancers without legs, isn't it? They dance on their hands. So we need to make some assumptions out of experiences, and the common thread is destiny and fate are two different things. Fate decides where you will be born and when and where you will die. Destiny is what you make out of your fate. Various scriptures agree on one philosophy, and that is, what you sow, so shall you reap. The law of karma is another view of the same thing. So we assume that within the framework, it's our choice as to what we put. A lot is written about goal setting. Goal is a destination where you plan to go as on today. And equally important is to understand where you are standing today. Because knowing where you are and where you wish to go gives you various options. You can go by road, sea, air, or any other means to travel depending on the resources you currently have. It is more important to reach there with least effort, as law of harvesting is to reap more than you sow. नाम न जाने गांव का बिन जाने कित जाऊं चलता चलता जुग भया दोन कोस पर गांव. This is a thought written by Saint Kabirdas, who was a 15th century mystic poet from India. He says that he has been wandering and searching all his life without knowing the name of the village he wanted to go, and finally he came to know that the village was just 2 miles away. A very important thought, put so simply, most of us do not know where we are heading, and we are like driftwood in the sea. Yes, we all dream, we all decide a goal, and it doesn't end there all the time. The big question is, how do we go there? Can we go there without a road map? We know traveling is much, much easier with a map. We can find the best route and the shortest route to reach there. We know where we need to rest, where we need to stop. So we need to have a plan, and if the plan doesn't work, we need to change the plan and not alter the goal. A goal has to be smart, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. I wish to reduce my weight by 5 kg in the year 2016. Yes, my goal is specific. It can be measured. It can be achieved, but it's a bit stretched, and that is okay. And it's relevant, and it's time-bound. If I would say that at the age of 57, I wish to be Mr. Universe, it is not relevant for me. If I say I wish to reduce some weight, it doesn't make my goal specific, and what is not specific cannot be achieved. Success is a word very loosely used, but success is something which is very relative to time and to people. In spite of best of achievement, people will not feel that you have been successful. Real success is when you call it a day, when you say to yourself that I gave my best shot in life. If you feel so, that is real success. Success is when preparation meets opportunity. And I would say success is when preparation meets opportunity and adversity both. Success is working hard in silence and let the people make a noise about it. Again, success achieved by an individual is not important. If his success doesn't inspire others to be successful, you can get all the riches of the world with all the hard work you do. And if that doesn't leave the world as a better place, then that success is of no worth to anybody. So more important than goal is purpose. And where there is purpose, means will follow. Mother Teresa had a purpose and means still follow after she is gone. Four important questions we need to ask for ourselves and our children. What is our God-given talent? Everyone has some unique talent, and everyone is unique in his own way. A fish can't climb a tree and bird can't swim in deep water. So what has nature given us? Then what is my potential? What is the purpose that I wish to fulfill with my talent? And lastly, did I try my best? If Elvis Presley would have tried boxing, would he be a king of music? Most of us die even without knowing what special talent nature gave us. Talent is God-given, be humble. Fame is man-given, be grateful. Pride is self-given, be careful. Talent mixed with practice gets converted to skills, and skills lead you to goal more often. For someone to balance may be a natural talent, but he will need lot of practice to turn it into skill, so that even while he is sleeping, he can balance himself on a rope. This is when talent and practice gets into your subconscious and makes it a way of life for you and me. All big shots were small shots, and they kept shooting. Is there anyone who became a star as soon as he is born? They identify what they are good at, what they enjoy, and they work so hard in silence that you are not able to hear them in the noise of parties that you are attending. Someone asked Muhammad Ali, how many push-ups does he do? He said, he doesn't count. He starts counting after it starts hurting him. We do 100 push-ups and the most difficult one is the 101th. But if we leave that 101, then the whole 100 push-ups go waste. Each one of us puts some efforts and there is an effort to return ratio. Each of us puts 8 to 10 hours of hard work. And why is there a difference in return? The quantum of effort does not matter. It's about the value in that effort. Each one of us have a market value. This market value depends on the law of demand and supply. Our market value also depends on the options we have during the process of transaction. We need to position ourselves at a point where we have more options and the other party has less options. Engineers know the advantage of a lever or a gear ratio. A long lever with a fulcrum point closer to the object can push a heavy stone, and this is called mechanical advantage. A small gear turning a big gear can increase the output power of the output gear. Similarly, when our effort is exclusive, we get a premium for being exclusive for the same amount of effort. What is exclusive today may not be exclusive tomorrow. So we need to be evolving continuously over a period of time. Since the time we are born, we start the transaction process with this universe of the system. We give happiness to the parents and they give us care, love, security, food, education. So there are million ways we give and million ways we get back in return. We give smile, we get happiness. What we can give is in our control, but when will the system pay us back is not in our control. System will give back when it thinks we need it. The trick is to get more back from the system. We can make a pie chart of what we give and what we get. There are some things we can quantify, some we cannot quantify, like blessing the elder, love from children can't be quantified. Try making a pie chart of what you give and what you get, and you will see that the diameter of our pie charts are much smaller than that of Warren Buffett. How many hours does he live in a day? 24. And that is what we do. But the art is in increasing the circle of the pie chart. Great people achieve more in 24 hours than what we achieve. There are several types of efforts a person puts in life. One, linear, directional, and complementary, in which effort adds to the last effort, and there is incremental growth towards the goal. Second, non-linear and non-complementary. It is like a driftwood in the sea. The efforts don't complement and has no direction at all. Third, non-linear and multi-skilling. For example, a man can sing and play all instruments of orchestra. Bruce Lee said that, I am not scared of a person who has practiced 1000 kicks, but he is scared of a person who has practiced one kick 1000 times. We always are a part of some group or multiple groups. Like I am a part of group defined as technical consultant. I am also a part of group called motivators. Like Samsung today is a part of mobiles using Android. If Samsung has to retain its position in mobile phones, it will have to keep on differentiating itself from other handsets, or they will die like BlackBerry or Nokia. And today in competitive world, it will take minutes for us to get obsolete. You can see that as we graduate from college, different students take different directions. Some educate further, some start working and studying. A heart surgeon will charge ₹1,000,000 for one surgery, whereas a general physician won't be able to earn that much in a year. It is about exclusivity, and since heart surgery is risky and availability of master surgeons is less, he can demand more price. So doing things which are risky is also a big differentiator. Like any other thing, exclusivity or differentiation needs a strategic roadmap or a plan. Exclusivity has no value that can be compared, but you can measure your own value. I am a part of say 100,000 consultants in India, so my rating will be 1 divided by 100,000. But after doing my PhD, I am now part of say 100 consultants who have got a doctorate degree. So my rating now will be 1 divided by 100. And that's how we can calculate and measure for ourselves and compare whether we are rising above the crowd or not. Today I was reading in newspaper that nurses are in high demand in Australia, England, New Zealand, and Indian nurses are moving out and changing their league. So what takes to go there? One has to imagine the profile required, do a strength, weakness, opportunity, threat analysis, and aptitude, skill, knowledge analysis, and find the gaps and fill those gaps by educating themselves and preparing themselves for that opportunity. We have to treat ourselves as a brand. Brand is what fetches value. A Nike shoe would cost 5,000 Indian rupees for its brand name, and Bata shoe may cost 2,000 rupees for the same quality. and without a brand name it would cost 1,000 rupees. Coffee at Starbucks costs 180 rupees against coffee in any Indian coffee shop, which is 10 rupees. We as human beings have to brand ourselves. We are in two categories. One is when we are behind brand, and other is when brands are behind us. There are two kinds of activities we do: value added and non-value added. Eating chips, watching TV doesn't add value. Cycling and watching TV adds value. We need to add one value every day, and we have 365 things we have learned when other people are partying. And in 1 year, you are much more evolved than your competition. Make a list of activity and we call it value stream mapping, and eliminate activities that don't add value. That is applicable to our business activities too. There are several exclusive attributes in a person, product or organization. You need to identify the value mesh you can provide: character, honesty, timeliness, cleanliness, intelligence, perseverance, and there are many other exclusive values. But the two most important values are one who can bring in a change and one who can make things happen. If we have these two characteristics, we are valuable to the person using us. Why is Narendra Modi selected as PM of India? Because he can bring in a change in this country. What fetches higher returns? Branding, packaging, aesthetic, pride of position, superior quality, higher risk, innovation, creativity, convenience, comfort, courage, and many other things. Why do people go in a BMW to their club? Because of pride of possessing a BMW. Why has Tata hired Messi as the brand ambassador? As he will be able to make an emotional connect for the brand, and the brand would revive the sales for Tata Motor. So Messi being exclusive, all brands want to ride his brand image. Having said that, we need to plan our journey and calibrate our goals and journey as time passes. Goals can be calibrated and strategy can be changed. I have a goal of 10 kg weight reduction. I tried for 6 months different techniques, but no change took place. So I switched to boiled vegetables and I see change happening. Now to reduce 5 kg or 10 kg in 6 months may seem irrelevant and not achievable. So I make it 3 kg for the remaining 6 months. This is how we need to budget and plan our life like a business plan of a company. This is a poem I have written. I will bounce back and will finish the race. Most times in life, we try to do something we have a goal to achieve, but we are not able to reach over there. And we are left behind by other people. But it is not important to win every race in life. It is important that we finish the race and our conscience tells us that we gave the best shot. So let's summarize. Make a list of things you are good at, make a list of things which you are not good at, identify what you enjoy doing, identify the group you belong to, identify your strength, weakness, opportunity and threats, identify the purpose of your life, identify one person who you would like to become, identify people who can help you take there, identify the gap between the model person and you, define your ambition, identify the step that will take you there, make a plan, start your actions, adjust your actions. And I wish you all the best and thanks for listening this presentation so patiently. Be somebody. If you find this presentation useful, please share it with other people. You can always contact me in person, www.samyconsulting.com, or you can mail me on samyconsulting@gmail.com. Thank you very much.